I must admit she's an attractive woman. I wouldn't mind seeing her again sometime.
It'll be fun. Take the stand. Answer simply and directly.
Silence! All rise! All persons having mass before this court, draw near and give your attention. The Honorable Francis Rayford presiding. Be seated.
So it's really very simple. We have a judge, the symbol of justice here, who is accused of raping and brutally beating this young girl right here. Now, we can do something about it. And we can do it today, and we can do it together. Now, let's make this our goal line stand. Just give me a verdict of guilty. I need your help.
Prosecutor has completed his opening statement. Defense counsel ready?
Yes, Your Honor. Your Honor, Mr. Foreman, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my name is Arthur Kirkland, and I am the defense counsel for the defendant, Judge Henry T. Fleming. Now, that man over there, he's the prosecuting attorney. And he couldn't be happier today. He is a happy man today because today he's going after a judge. And if he gets him, he's going to be a star. He's going to have his name in this month's law review, Centerfold, Lawyer of the Month. Now, in order to win this case, he needs you, naturally. You're all he's got, believe me. So he's counting on tapping that emotion in you which says, let's get somebody in power. Let's get a judge. However, these proceedings are not about that. These proceedings are here to see that justice is done. And justice is, as any reasonable person would tell you, the finding of the truth. And what is the truth today? One truth, a tragic one, is that that girl has been beaten and raped. Another truth is that the prosecution doesn't have a witness, does not have one piece of substantiating evidence other than the testimony of the victim herself. Another truth is that my client voluntarily, and the prosecution is well aware of this fact, voluntarily took a lie detector test.
Objection, Your Honor, that's inadmissible evidence.
What?
Come on, Arthur.
Tell the truth.
The jury will disregard that remark. Polygraph tests have not been proven 100% reliable, therefore inadmissible in a court of law.
Sorry, Your Honor. Let's get back to justice. What is justice? What is the intention of justice? The intention of justice is to see that the guilty people are proven guilty and that the innocent are freed. Simple, isn't it? Only it's not that simple. However, it is the defense counselor's duty to protect the rights of the individual, as it is the prosecution's duty to uphold and defend the laws of the state. Justice for all. Only we have a problem here. You know what it is? Both sides want to win. We want to win. We want to win regardless of the truth, and we want to win regardless of justice, regardless of who's guilty or innocent. Winning is everything. That man there wants a win so badly today. It means so much to him. He is so carried away with the prospect of winning, the idea, that he forgot something that's absolutely essential to today's proceedings. He forgot his case. He forgot to bring it. I don't know. I don't see it. Do you? The prosecution's case. He's got to have one.
Not a witness, not one piece of substantiating evidence other than the testimony of the victim herself.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I have a case to end all cases.
I have witnesses for my client. I have character references, testimonials that are backed up from here to Washington, D.C. I got lie detector tests that have been...
Objection!
Objection! Objection to state.
Sit down, Frank.
Mr. Kirkland, you are out of order.
The one thing that bothered me, the one thing that stayed in my mind and I couldn't get rid of it, that haunted me, was why. Why would she lie? What was her motive for lying? If my client is innocent, she's lying. Why? Was it blackmail? No. Was it jealousy? No. Yesterday, I found out why. She doesn't have a motive. You know why? Because she's not lying. And ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the prosecution is not gonna get that man today. No. Because I'm gonna get him. My client, the Honorable Henry T. Fleming, should go right to fucking jail! The son of a bitch is guilty! That man is guilty! That man there! That man is a slime! He is a slime! If he's allowed to go free, then something really wrong is going on.
Mr. Kirkland, you are out of order.
You're out of order. You're out of order. The whole trial is out of order. They're out of order. That man, that sick,
all right,
crazy, depraved man, raped and beat that woman there, and he'd like to do it again. He told me so. It's just a show. It's a show. Let's make a deal. Let's make a deal. Hey, Frank, you want to make a deal? I got an insane judge who likes to beat the shit out of women. What do you want to give me, Frank? 3 weeks probation?
Damn it.
You son of a bitch. You're supposed to stand for something. You're supposed to protect people, but instead you fucking murder them.
Shut him up.
You killed McCullough. You killed him. Hold it. Hold it. I just completed my opening statement.